Thank you. I will try to describe or to introduce the implications in medical imaging of the new threshold for tissue reactions. And I am telling nothing new, just to correct that the date of April 2013 is a mistake, but the important value of the new threshold for the lens of the eyes of 0.5 rays and for the circulatory disease in the heart and brain, if doses are higher than 0.5 gray, is the main topic or the main aspect of my presentation. And we already, when we published the statement from the ICRP, we alerted the medical community that this threshold could be, or the doses we are managing in some of the interventional procedures for patients and for staff could be higher than these threshold values. And they will try to present you some of the real values in the real clinical work we are having today in, with some examples of the literature and some examples in the clinical practice in a big university hospital. In this case, is our hospital, but could be similar in other hospitals in your countries. And just try to conclude that we will need to improve the justification in some of these procedures and optimizations, especially optimization, and just to introduce this kind of topics in the training program of our clinicians to take into account that these doses or the doses to the heart, to the brain, to the lens of the eyes in some of the procedures could be higher than the new threshold. We have done some organ dose calculations in cardiac interventional procedures and in neuro radiology procedures, and also later we'll also present some data about the lens to the eyes in some of the IIA release surveys we have conducted in several countries, and I will present specifically some of the details in a large cardiology congress performed in Argentina some years ago. Well, concerning interventional cardiology procedures, the hair dose, we move the C-arm and the beam a lot during the procedure, but always we are trying to look the arteries, the coronary arteries, and always we have some dose to the heart, and approximately we try to do some kind of Monte Carlo calculation. The dose to the heart is approximately between 20 and 25%, could be 15 if we are using the collimation, of the total cumulative entrance erkerma. That is one parameter that now is offered by all the new system. Then, if the cumulative erkerma is higher than 2 or 2.5 grays, this involves a hair dose that could be higher than 0.5 grays. And we have taken the data we have in our university hospital for all the cardiac procedures we have in our database. We have a system to collect individually all the doses. And we have collected a total of about 6,500 procedures during the years 2010 and 2011. And look at the data that 10% of all the procedures, diagnostic and therapeutic, and 10% have a cumulative entrance kerma more than 2.5 grays, and 17% more than 2 grays. And this is all the practice, all the procedures we are using. But if we move now to the therapeutic procedures, all the complexity, PTCA, simple PTCA, but also some total coronary occlusions and so, look that 60% could have a kerma, a cumulative kerma higher than 2.5 grays, and 27% have a cumulative kerma more than 2 grays. Then this range could be between 16 and 27% of the procedures likely result in a hair dose higher than 0.5 grays to the heart as organ dose. But we have, unfortunately, in many of the cardiac procedures, very high doses in very complex procedures, like the total occlusions, and we arrive to have skin injuries. And until now, with the clinical protocols to follow some of the patients with high doses, we are following these cases with skin injuries, and we are taking care of the skin injuries during the clinical follow-up of the patients. But probably in the future, look that if we are estimating that in these cases, and we do this kind of skin dose distribution analysis, and we calculate the entrance dose in that area, but if we have 13 grays in some of these cases, the dose to the heart would be around 3-4 grays. And then probably in the follow-up of these patients, we will need to take into account in future this possibility of the tissue reactions. What's about interventional neuroradiology? We have tried to do a similar exercise. In this case, we have done a more selected calculation. We have taken a low number of procedures, but we have done the calculation individually for all the series of the images acquired. We have processed more than 9,000 series of images, and we have later distributed the fluoroscopy runs in these series. And in our normal practice, taking into account all the complexity, we are one university hospital, we come with a quite complex number of cases. 34% of the brain procedures were more than or have doses to the brain higher than 0.5 grays. Approximately every 1,000 milligrays at the entrance of the head involved in this kind of procedures, 2,070 grays. We should take into account, and we have taken into account in this calculation, the collimation in many of the cases and the difference in the beam quality. But what is about now with pediatric procedures in interventional? And we have used some of the data already published in the year 2008 with some of our colleagues in the States and in France. And the results presented in this paper published in 2008 for a detailed analysis of 49 neuroembolization. The paper was published trying to analyze the risk of cancer and so, but we have just used the data to look how is the range of the doses in this kind of procedures. And if it is also in pediatric procedures higher than 500 milligrays, 0.5 grays, and if in the calculation done by the authors, if there is no collimation, if it is part of the practice that unfortunately we still have with many of our colleagues clinicians, if we are not using collimation, in this sample of 49 neuroembolization, 43% have doses higher than 500 milligrays. And it is expected that many of these neuroembolization in these children will have repeated procedures later. But look at the impact of the optimization. If people is using the proper beam, if the collimation is well done, the same data, and we process the same data, the authors have processed the same data, this is already data published, with the same 49 neuroembolization, absolutely the dose to the brain is reduced. We are not irradiating the full brain, we are or the authors in the calculation suppose that it was only irradiated the lesion, and they suppose that the neuroradiologist is just trying to collimate, not only to improve image quality, just to reduce the dose to the organ. Then the conclusion is that the optimization of the procedure, and we will need to include that in our training programs to our clinicians, try to collimate not only to improve the image quality, not only to reduce the Kermare product, also to reduce a lot in this case, as you have seen, the dose to the brain. We have also some implication for occupational people, especially occupational people, and we have seen in the previous presentations that doses to the lens of the eyes could be also higher than 0.5 grays. But if we have the dose to the lens higher than 0.5 grays, we can also do some kind of estimation, and probably around 20%, 50% could be the dose to the brain. And if we look at some of the last publications about this RELIT program of the IAEA and the evaluation done with some of our colleagues working in cardiology, with two conditions, without protection in the last 30 or 40 years, and we do the retrospective evaluation because unfortunately many of these professionals have not used properly or regularly the personal dosimeters, we have found is not the full population, but we invite people to attend this kind of survey, voluntary. Could you be tested in your lens opacity, the possibility to have lens opacity during your congress? And some of the people worried because they have been working several years, go accept to be evaluated during the congress, and we arrived to found that approximately 50% of the interventional cardiologists attending the survey and 41% of the nurses have opacities in the lens, compatible with the opacities derived for a lack of protection to receive doses. And in our retrospective evaluation, we arrived to estimate that some of these colleagues working during 40 years without protection, they could arrive to have several sievers or several grays in the lens of the eyes. And if this is the dose received in the lens of the eyes, probably the dose to the brain also could be, in some cases, higher than 0.5 grays. And this is my last slide, is that the new threshold for tissue reactions and the need for a specific patient and the staff dose evaluation and follow-up. must be considered in radiation protection programs and should be included in the education and training of professionals involved in fluoroscopy-guided procedures. And I feel that this is a responsibility we have, a radiation protection community, to advise our colleagues to take into account this new risk and to consider in the optimization programs. Thank you.